Okay, Dr. Mindy here, and I have been down a rabbit hole of science, understanding what foods are damaging our body the most, and specifically our immune system, because even in this moment, we need to start focusing in on personal responsibility of our immune system. What can we do to keep our immune system at its best? And even as this virus comes and goes, immune system has never been more important for us to focus on. And literally, you guys, all roads are pointing to one food. There is one specific food that will make you more vulnerable, shut down your immune system, increase the aging process, give you more aches and pains, and you gotta get off this one food. So on this video, I'm gonna show you what that one food is. I'm gonna stay tuned all the way through because I'm gonna give you some suggestions for reversing the damage of this one food. And as always, I brought you science. So ton of science, be sure to look in the links if you wanna see the studies that I'm citing in here, know that that's available to you as well. But excited to share this video with you, and please take a moment at the end of this video to just really ask yourself what you can do right now to give up this one food. Okay, Dr. Mindy here, and I have got some really serious science for you guys today that I really want to make sure that you understand this principle because it legitimately could be life-saving. So what I'm going to share with you is a very specific food that we know will cause both immediate damage to your cells and long-term damage to your cells. And it does this through a series of degeneration or reactions in the body called oxidative stress. So sit tight with me. I'm going to simplify it for you. You guys know that I love to simplify the science, but I want you to understand the big picture, because if I stand up here and I just say, don't eat this, you won't understand why. I want you to understand why this food is so dangerous for you to be eating. And I'm gonna put it in terms of what we're dealing with right now with the coronavirus, okay? So let's start with this. We know with the coronavirus, I know there's been a lot of theories about how it takes over the body, but one of the things that we know why this is such a dangerous virus is because it will shut down or decrease something called ACE2 inhibitors, which some of you have probably heard before. It also increases oxidative stress, and that increase in oxidative stress will lead to thrombosis, which is what's happening to people as they fall prey to this virus, okay? So originally, we thought with this virus that one of the major problems would be people who already had lung conditions. So they already had like a lung challenge or COPD, like they already had a pre-existing lung situation. And what they're realizing is that is not the case. The people that are falling prey to this virus are people that already had accelerated oxidative stress going on in their bodies. And the oxidative stress shows up as things like an elevated BMI. That's just a fancy word for saying obesity. So people who are more obese tend to fall prey and have worse symptoms with this virus than people who aren't. And that's due to oxidative stress. We also know people who have kidney disease or cardiovascular disease or diabetes, all of those people have a higher level of oxidative stress. Therefore, they are weathering this virus worse. Now, why this is applicable beyond just the virus topic is that oxidative stress will accelerate aging, it will increase inflammation, and it will make you more vulnerable to the virus. And there is one food, you guys, like one food that science keeps saying over and over and over again that is creating more oxidative stress than any other. And it is the food you've got to get off of. And I want to walk you through those, and we'll talk a little bit about how you get off of it. And that food is fructose. Now, if you're listening to this, you may don't shut off the video at this point. You might say to yourself, well, fructose is in fruit. What is exactly is fructose? So let me start off. I'm going to answer that question, but let me start off by explaining what we know based off of science, and I'm going to put it in terms of the coronavirus, that fructose is doing to cause a situation within the body that allows this virus to proliferate and do more damage than necessary. So here are some of the things that we know about fructose. Fructose, not only does it increase oxidative stress, like I talked about, but it inhibits enzymes that make vitamin D bioavailable. Why this is important? Let's say you heard me on a video say vitamin D is the best thing that you can do right now to raise your immune system, and you're taking your vitamin D, and then an hour later you're drinking a Coke, or you're eating a pastry or something that has fructose in it. And what we know is that it will, even a great quality supplement, it will inhibit the absorption of vitamin D into your cells and will make it less bioavailable, which means that you're wasting your money on your supplement. You're wasting your time out in the sun because fructose will make it so that vitamin D is less bioavailable. Okay. But that's not the only thing. The second thing is that, or the third thing is that it will increase, it'll inhibit your glutathione production. Okay, glutathione is made by your mitochondria, and you need glutathione to be able to clean up the cells. You also need glutathione to be able to fight viruses. Well, fructose inhibits the production of glutathione. Okay, but that's not it. The other thing, and this is crazy important, and I don't know why we're not, we got to get this out to the masses, is that with the coronavirus, fructose will cover the coronavirus and will create an armor around the coronavirus so that your immune system cannot identify it. That means that it can wreak more havoc within your body because it camouflages itself within the sugar molecules that are broken down from fructose. Okay, so if you want your immune system to not register the virus, then make sure that you're doing lots of fructose. And I break down the different types of fructose, so sit tight with me. And then the last thing that I want to point out is these ACE2 receptor sites. This part of the immune system, when there you have a diet that's high in fructose, what's happening is that it will make it so that the virus can attach itself to these ACE2 inhibitors and take over your immune system. So it's a little bit like a cancer cell. When a cancer cell goes rogue, now we've got a problem and it's very difficult to go after. The same thing when a coronavirus has sugar to live off of, it has fructose to live off of, it will shut off that immune system, it will do more oxidative damage. It will tone down your vitamin D. It'll tone down your glutathione. We have to get you off the fructose at this point in time. And it's not just for what we're dealing with as a world and a country right now. You know, America, by the way, has the highest level of fructose consumption across the world, which is why right now, it's June, we're seeing such a prevalence of the coronavirus in America. So, what do I mean by fructose? So here's a couple of really important points that I want to point out, or I want to mention to you guys, that there are three different types of sugar, and fructose is just a fancy term for sugar. The one that is the most damaging is high fructose corn syrup. And you are going to find it in your sodas. You're going to find it in your cookies and your cakes and your salad dressings. You're going to find it in sauces and canned fruit and juice. So please make sure that you are reading labels and you are avoiding high fructose corn syrup at all costs right now. That is the most damaging version of fructose that you can possibly eat. It's what we call a simple carbohydrate. You're gonna drink it, you're gonna eat it, it's gonna go into your system very fast, and it's gonna do all those things that I just told you. It's gonna shut down your immune system, it's gonna increase oxidative stress, it's gonna shut down vitamin D and glutathione just from one can of Coke, just from one cookie that it's going to take that sugar and it's going to create this oxidative stress that's going to be a massive problem for you, okay? The second sugar that I want you to think about is something called sucrose. Now, you can find these on the labels. Start reading the labels so you understand and teach your kids to read the labels. Teach your family members to read the labels. So sucrose is 50% fructose and it's 50% glucose. So it's not 100% fructose and high fructose corn syrup. It's not 100%, but that's 50%. And you're gonna find it more in your grains and your cereals, your processed meats. I point it out to you because start looking for the word sucrose in your labels. Read your labels so that if you see fructose, if you see sucrose, if you see high fructose corn syrup, put it back. Okay, and then the third thing, and I know you guys are thinking this, what about fruit? Well, here's what's the difference with fruit. Fruit is a complex carbohydrate, whereas high fructose corn syrup, sucrose, those are simple carbohydrates. They go into your bloodstream, and all of a sudden you start, it can shut the immune system down. It can cause the oxidative stress to happen quickly. Whereas fruit has fiber in it, and it is a complex carbohydrate. And so it's going to react differently. So I am not saying to get off fruit. I know a lot of you guys that are keto, you minimize fruit, but there is some great research showing that fruit, people who have a diet high in vegetables and fruit actually have less oxidative damage to their cells. So I'm talking about the more simple carbohydrates, the sucrose and the high fructose corn syrup. Those are the ones that are damaging you the most. Okay, so what do you do if this is you? What if you've been eating all this fructose for so long? How do you undo the oxidative damage? Well, for you guys, there's good news because research study after research study shows that intermittent fasting is one of the best ways to bring oxidative stress down. So if you are not intermittent fasting right now, if you have not adopted a lifestyle of intermittent fasting, now is the time to do it. Okay, second thing, exercise. So something as simple as exercise, especially if you're doing like high intensity exercise like we're doing in my Reset Academy, that will bring down the oxidative stress levels. It can help reverse the damage that has been done. But then you can even go on and you can look at things like, hold on, eating more fruits and vegetables. That's an easy one. And then if you go and you look back and you say, okay, well, I've been eating a lot of fructose. What do I do now? You can start to bring your vitamin D levels back up. Get out in the sun. If you use great products like DV3, we love, increase your glutathione levels. So use products like G-Cell, love this product for raising up the glutathione. And then the greatest supplement for oxidative stress that I would add into your regimen right now is called ROX. And this is made specifically to help repair the cells that have been damaged from oxidative stress. So this one food, you guys, like one food, if we get you off of fructose right now, you're gonna have as much of a benefit on your immune system, if not more, than wearing a mask or distancing, social distancing. I'm not saying to stop those things. I'm just asking you to look at there are habits that we are doing that are suppressing our immune system, that are making us more vulnerable, that are causing the spread of this virus right now, that are accelerating aging, that are causing us to be insulin resistant. And it all starts with one food, and that's fructose. So if you're not convinced, I'm leaving all the science. I got multiple articles to show you everything that I just talked about, but literally from the bottom of my heart, please get off the fructose. If that's a challenge, we're here to support you. I plan on doing more videos on how do you unhook yourself from that sugar addiction that so many people have. So if that's of interest to you, just put it in the comments, let me know. And we are gonna do, in July, we're gonna do another metabolic reset. And this is where we teach you how to use keto and fasting so that you can undo the damage that perhaps years of fructose living has done for you. So as always, I hope that helps.